Building just one lengthy double composite viaduct on a constrained site in leafy Buckinghamshire would have been challenging enough on its own. But the EKFB joint venture, building HS2 in the south, are building two within the space of just 3 kilometres, all while trying to keep a road and railway open. The Wendover and Smaldean viaducts are located to the south of Wendover, with the Wendover-Dean viaduct crossing a recess in a hill, whilst the Smaldean viaduct, which is actually closer to Wendover, will cross the London to Aylesbury line and the A413. Both of the viaducts provide unique challenges, which drove the decision to use what is called a push-launch method of construction, which is also referred to as a bridge or deck slide. The unique challenges also means that the structures are the first major railway viaducts in the UK to use double composite construction. I'll talk more about the launch method shortly, but first I wanted to explain what double composite means. In terms of the Wendover and Smaldean viaducts, double composite means a structure which is constructed out of steel and concrete. This is nothing new and is a common construction method these days. But in this instance, the steel beams are sandwiched between the concrete layer on the top and bottom to create a hollow structure which is incredibly strong, but relatively lightweight. The steel beams have been constructed out of 23 to 25 metre long weathering steel sections, which were welded together on site. The steel beams were manufactured in France, so the size of each section was dedicated by what could practically be delivered by road and ferry. I think in a previous video about the Wendover Viaduct, I may have said that EKFB couldn't find a UK manufacturer to construct the precision engineered beam. But what I should have said is a UK manufacturer couldn't be found at the time to deliver the beams when needed. But similar beams being used on other parts of HS2 have been manufactured in the UK. Once on site, the beams were welded together in parallel to form the bridge deck section. In the case of the Wendover-Dean viaduct, which is 450 metres long, these steel sections were welded together to form bridge sections ranging in length from 90 to 180 metres long. Whereas the Smaldean viaduct, which is 350 metres long, is being assembled in one go. There are two reasons for this. First, there is more space close to the southern abutment for the Smaldean viaduct to be assembled in one go, whereas space was at a premium for the Wendover viaduct. The Smaldean viaduct must also cross the A413 and the Aylesbury line, so it would be best if the bridge was pushed into place using a single bridge slide. This brings us on to the push-launch method of construction. Basically, it's almost like it sounds. The completed deck section is pushed, or more accurately pulled, into position using a winch and pulley system. So, in the case of the Wendover viaduct, it was slid into position over a number of slides, and after each slide, another section of deck was assembled. This meant that during the initial bridge slide, the deck weighed only 590 tons. But by the time it came to the final slide, the deck weighed 3,700 tons. To ease the slide, workers had to manually insert Teflon pads in between temporary bearings atop the piers and the bridge deck. This reduced the friction and made the whole slide possible. The Smaldean viaduct, which is being assembled in one go, will weigh 4,300 tons during the push, despite being the shorter of the two viaducts. The reason for this is the precast concrete panels, which form the sandwich, will be pre-installed prior to the launch, whereas the panels on the Wendover viaduct were installed after the slide. Pre-assembly of the Smaldean viaduct means that the A413 will only have to close for one day during the 5 days that it is anticipated the slide will take. The railway will, however, have to remain closed during the entire process. The only reason for the road closure is that it is feared that the sight of the large red guide cantilevering over the road could cause drivers to become distracted. Once the guide has passed over the road, however, it will be safe for drivers to pass underneath, and for the most part, they'll be none the wiser. The pre-assembled deck will be completely watertight. Therefore, the concrete layer, which will be poured after the launch, can be poured without the need to close the road. This concrete layer will bind the precast concrete panels to the steel beams, in addition to the precast concrete parapets, which will be installed after the launch. The Wendover Viaduct is somewhat similar to the Small Dean structure. However, the parapets for the Wendover Viaduct will be built using what is known as a form traveller. This is a movable mould into which rebar is placed and concrete is poured. Then, once cured, the movable mould is moved to construct the next parapet section. The use of two different construction methods for the parapets is due to the unique challenges faced for each viaduct, despite being so close together and using broadly the same construction method. As the Small Dean Viaduct passes over a busy road and railway, then working above the road and railway needs to be kept to a minimum. Whereas the Wendover Dean Viaduct is much taller, with the tallest pier standing at 14 metres high. So it's beneficial to keep lifting operations to a minimum, which is where the form traveller comes in. Speaking of lifting operations, another way of saying lifting something with a crane, the piers for both the viaducts were constructed using precast concrete shells, which were then lifted into place, with three shells, which were manufactured in Ireland, used for each pier, which comprised of two lower sections and a 45-ton hammerhead. Although the shells look substantial, they are not the main load-bearing elements of the piers, and were used more like moulds into which pre-assembled rebar cages were placed and concrete poured. The benefit of pre-assembly for the shells is that a very high quality finish can be delivered. The Wendover Viaduct was pushed into its final position on the 11th of August, and since then the process of lowering the deck from the temporary bearings around 60 centimetres onto the permanent bearings has been underway. This involves lifting sections of the deck with hydraulic jacks, and then lowering the section by 20 centimetres at a time until they're sitting on the permanent bearings. The deck for the Small Dean Viaduct was largely complete when I visited in August. However, the bridge slide is not due to take place until early 2025. Although both viaducts are using the same double composite method of construction, they will look somewhat different, with the Wendover structure designed to be more sleek in appearance, whereas the Small Dean deck will be more visible, and as such, designers wanted the bridge to be more iconic, with a nod to older plate girder style bridges, which is formed with the use of the steel fins protruding from the sides, atop which will sit the concrete parapets. The Wendover and Small Dean viaducts are impressive, but are just 2 out of 50 significant viaducts that are being built on the route between London and Birmingham, which is a subject that I'll be looking into in a future video. So be sure to subscribe so you don't miss that.